Welcome to another Educating the Believers broadcast from Augusta, Georgia, with pastor and teacher Curtis A. Merriweather. Pastor Merriweather is an anointed Word of Faith minister. He has been teaching the Word of Faith for over 41 years. He places a strong emphasis on you knowing the principles of faith, your authority as a believer, and who you are in Christ. We hope that you'll enjoy this message with Pastor Merriweather.
Then we begin to look at ways in order to receive our healing. We share with you 11 ways that if you are sick, how to receive your healing. We started out with number one, the best way, and we said that's acting from a position or a knowledge of the word. Well, you must know. You must have a knowledge of the will of God concerning healing yourself. I know what God says. This is my right. Jesus paid for it. So if he paid for it, I don't have to do anything in order to pay for it. Then we gave you the second one, the anointing with oil. Number three, the laying on of hands. Number four, through gifts of healings. Number five, the prayer of faith. Number six, the gift, the prayer of agreement. Number seven, speaking faith-filled words over your life. Number eight, partaking of the Lord's Supper. Number nine, having faith in the name of Jesus. Number 10, praying to the Father in Jesus' name. And number 11, through special anointings. Now, this morning, I want to talk about some misunderstanding. I should say some major misunderstanding about divine healing. Most people do not have an accurate knowledge concerning divine healing or healing of any sort from the Bible. So we want to look at some misunderstanding when it comes to healing. I want to just talk about a few of them. Number one, we want to talk about how does sickness come? Just how do sickness come? See, because many believers are trying to discover how to receive healing for their body. But what they really need to find out is how they got sick in the first place. Now, they looking at, how can I get healed? Well, I think the question they need to ask themselves, how did this come on me in the first place? Now, if they can ever find the answer to that question, they can make corrections and get their healing. A pastor told me this. He said he was ministering to a lot of his members in his church. And he had a doctor that was a member of his church. The doctor told him at service, he said, Pastor, I can tell you how to get all of them healed. He said, most of them just need to lose about 40 or 50 pounds. He said, they'll get their healing. See, a lot of people going in having special knee surgery, don't they? Listen, man, if all of a sudden I weigh 400 pounds and I need some knee surgery, tell me what happened if I drop out 250 pounds of that. I tell you, my joints will feel a whole lot better, wouldn't it? Well, we need to find out, okay. Let's ask the right questions. So, but we want to understand how sickness come to us. Now, we all understand this, I would say. Where sickness and disease originate from, it originate from the devil, right? We understand that it don't come from God. You got to understand that Satan influences you by circumstances. Let me show you how the devil operates when it comes to sickness and disease. The devil will come and he'll hit your body with some boom. And guess what? You'll say, hush. Now, right behind that sneeze, he'll tell you, you coming out with the flu. Now, but guess what? Most people gonna agree with him and say, you know, I must be coming down with the flu. And guess what? When you say that, you done signed for the package. And guess what? You don't even know you done it. It started with something so little, something so small. It started with a thought. Maybe a little pain or a little discomfort. But by the words of your mouth and your action, you sign for the package unknowingly. You accepted it and don't know that you the one that opened yourself up for whatever that you're dealing with. They don't have a clue. We understand that if I eat certain food, it's going to run my cholesterol level up, right? Okay, I remember me and my wife, we was talking, and one of the politicians that was running for the office of president, and they checked their health, and they say, well, you know, he just got a high level, his cholesterol level's kind of high. And Helen say, well, you know, rich folks always have high cholesterol. I say, we're rich. I ain't got high cholesterol. You ain't got high cholesterol. But you know, rich do eat rich food, don't they? Well, when we get to heaven, the Lord gonna say, now this is the reason why you up here sooner than you should. This is the reason why you've been sick, because of this. Most folks don't know how things happen. They just don't know how the devil operates. Now, let me show you what the Bible says. Let's go to 2 Corinthians and see if what I said is true. 2 Corinthians, let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 11. Yeah, Satan hits your body with something. And soon as he hits your body with something, he shoots a thought to your mind and tell you, you got this. An average person be in agreement with it. And they tell somebody or they tell themselves, you know, I must be coming down with this. And when they say that, they done signed for the package and accepted it. Well, you at 2 Corinthians? Listen at 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. Are you there? Listen to what it says. Less or so that Satan should not get an advantage of us. Mean that Satan shouldn't outsmart us. See, God don't want him to have an advantage over you. But guess what? When you're not in the know, a person have an advantage over you, don't they? You know, it's just like kids. I'm sure some of y'all done this. You know, when you were small kids, that you took advantage of your brothers or sister or family member. You probably had a bag full of coins and they had paper money. They probably say, I trade you. See, you took advantage of them, didn't you? You know, you had that bag and it was full with them coins. They got the paper stuff, and you traded them. Well, you took advantage of them, didn't you? Well, God don't want the devil to take advantage of us. But if we are unaware of his tricks, the Bible says in this verse we're going to read, devices, his schemes, his sly ways, well, he got the advantage of us. Let's read it again. It says, lest that Satan should get an advantage of us or outsmart us, we are not ignorant or unaware of his devices, as his schemes, his sly ways. Do you know Satan's schemes? Do you know his sly ways? Do you know things that he do in order to take advantage of you? Do you know that once he hits your body with something, and he shot a thought to your mind and spoke to you, and you said what you said, do you realize that you signed for the package? No, most people don't. Most people are totally unaware. They ignorant in that area. Let's go to Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. See, God don't want you to be ignorant. Because the scripture says, for we are not ignorant of his devices. Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. Listen at this verse. Because we're trying to find out, how does sickness come? And how the devil operate? He just shoot a thought to our mind. And a lot of times folks are in total agreement. They start talking it. A little pain. Hit their knees. Oh. They start rubbing it. And then they start speaking over it. Ain't nothing good. They ain't saying, I'm by stripes, I'm healed now. They ain't saying none of that. I guess I'm coming now where, you know, I am approaching 60. I'm in my 60s now. I am knocking at the door of 70. I guess I'm coming down. Well, you know, my grandmama had this. See, do you realize that you're signing a package for something? You had Hosea 4, 6. Listen what it says. My people are what? Destroyed for or because of a what? Lack of knowledge. That means that they are ignorant along certain lines. Do you know lack of knowledge means ignorance? Uninformed, unaware. See, when you lack knowledge, you ignorant along a certain line, ain't it? Meaning that you ain't totally dumb on everything. It just may be just this area that destroying you. You ignorant in that area. You uninformed in that area. You lack knowledge in that area. You unaware about God's healing in this area. God says people are destroyed. Now why, God? Because they lack knowledge. And when you lack knowledge, that means you ignorant along a certain line, ain't it? That means that you uninformed. See, really, I thought I was dumb in life. I know you probably ain't ever believe that, but I used to walk around and I thought I was dumb. The only reason why I thought I was dumb because I couldn't read. Now, trust me, one word from God will set you free. God told me, say, Kurt, you're not dumb. You just didn't know how to read. Well, I failed to look at what I can do with my hands, how I can manage money. I know a lot of people that got college education, they can read anything. They can't work with their hands, and they sure can't handle no money. I was just ignorant in one area. Not totally across the board. But God says, my people are destroyed for or because of a lack of knowledge. You lack knowledge in a certain area. That's what destroying you. That's what defeating you. You need to gain knowledge in that area that's defeating you. And when you are defeated in an area, that's a signal that you don't have knowledge in that area. I often say Christian people are lazy folks. Well, when it comes to the things of God. See, because they may be a hustler out in the world or, you know, diligent in this area. But when it comes to God's word and the things of God, they lazy. They don't put forth the effort in order to have real victory in their life. How bad do you want victory? Okay, y'all don't sound like y'all want it. Tell me this. How many people want to be able to have enough money to do whatever they want to do in life? How many people? Okay. Nah. See, number one, I know most people is not honest with themselves. They letting a dime out of every dollar keep them from living the high life. See, because if you really wanted victory in your finances, you say, wait a minute, I'm going to stop shortchanging God. He is my source. He is the one that's going to cause me to live like I really want to live. Mm-hmm. Now, I know that. In the past, I had decent jobs, but not the best paying job for what I could do in my profession. I made enough money to take care of my family. I remember I was working for an apartment complex, and we had to call an outsider contractor in order to do a job. And when he got there, he had talked to me because I was the maintenance man. He finally said, man, you know how to do this. I said, I just ain't got the equipment to do it. He told me, say, I'll hire you right now. I'll pay you far more than what they would pay you. And it talked it interested. And he said, now, you work 5 days a week, and every other week that you may be on call on a Sunday. I said, that's where he lost me. I pastor church. So I couldn't take a better job because of what I was doing. Well, I didn't have the top paying jobs, but I honored God with the money that I made. And I found out, that you can talk to pastors all over this nation. I don't care what size congregation that they have, large or small. They would tell you predominantly, now this don't cover everybody, but predominantly, they'll say the most people that's tithe and they honestly tithe in their church is people with low-paying jobs. You want to know why? Ask me why. Because them the ones that realize that God, if you're going to cause me to prosper, you're the only one that's going to be able to do it because I can't deal with this paycheck here. The ones that make, good salaries, a lot of them don't think they need God. But you done factored out your help down the road. I'm telling you something that I know. Been doing this for 40 and a half years. Now, how do I know it's been 40 and a half years? Well, me and my wife, I told her the other day. I said, baby, you know that we've been married now for 40 years and 6 months. Once I got saved, I got married. And once I got saved, my mother told me about tithing. And I start tithing right then and there. Now, I may not lack knowledge in that area, but I may be having a lack of knowledge in this area. See, the Bible tells us to study to show ourselves approved unto God. Well, because you mastered something in this area, don't mean you got something mastered over in this area. See, and that's what people fail to realize. Well, I'm doing fine. Okay, well, you may be doing fine there, but what about here? I know this guy. Man, you talking about a great daddy? He's a good daddy. Man, he cook, he clean, he take care of his kids. I told my wife, I'll marry him. I told my, man, he's a good daddy. But guess what? A terrible husband. Terrible husband. Therefore, his kids, help his kids with the homework, all that stuff. And I ain't about all that. My grandkids, they came to live with us. And every day, granddaddy, I need some help on this. Well, help on cooking. Come on, boy, let me show you how to work this problem out. They came home, granddad, I made F on that. Oh, that was all wrong. I say, that's why I send you to school. You listen. Look, you can be great in one area and not so great in another. Man, this guy was a good father to his kids. But he didn't apply the same principle to his marriage. If he had worked on his relationship with his wife, amen, they would have been still married today. Amen, Jesus. Would have been still married today. You can be highly developed in one area and sadly lacking in another. We already got down. God says, my people are destroyed for what? A lack of knowledge. Well, when you are defeated in a certain area of your life, that's a signal. It should be a signal to you that you're lacking knowledge in that area. All you gotta do, I mean, just do the math. How much math, how much does it take? Okay, well, I'm doing good over in this area. Now, why is I'm doing so good in this area? Well, you know, I got a lot of knowledge in this area. Now, while I'm not doing too well in this area, well, I don't know nothing about this. So, how sickness come? Man, Satan is clever. He's slick. He outsmart a lot of folks, and they don't get the clue. So if we would go back and trace certain conditions that's in our life, we'll say, wait a minute. I do remember saying, I'm going to have this. And guess what? It may not show up tomorrow. But you go and tell folks, well, you know, and you hear people say this, I believe I'm going to get cancer. I got a family member. Every time they get ready, a lady, every time they get ready to go to the doctor office, they all nervous, shaking. All nervous, just shaking, all upset. Why? They afraid the doctor gonna tell them some bad news, you got this. But you gotta stop living in fear. Amen. And that's what people do, they constantly live in fear. Think, I'm gonna get this. Well, keep on thinking that. Keep on thinking it. Keep on believing it. Because when you believe in this and living in fear, you know, swung the door wide open. Then you come home, you see all these cats in your house, all on your kitchen table. You know, you done left your little sweet potato pie, apple pie up on the counter. They all up on the counter eating out of it. You left the door open, didn't you? He hit your body with something. And then as soon as he hit your body, throw a thought to your mind. And you say the same thing he say. And guess what? We don't think twice about it. A light bulb don't even go off, do it? And if you like I am, you know, towards your wife or husband, you know, something happened, you know, I sit down and talk to my wife. You know, if I see something on TV, I say, you know, Helen, this is what I just seen on TV. Well, the husband goes, you know what, I think I'm coming out with the flu. That's what the devil just told you. You know, you just sneeze, and he's, phew. You coming out with the flu. Oh, just because I sneeze, huh? Then you see how the world system have us programmed? Cause you sneeze, does that mean you coming out with the flu? But that's what everybody say, don't they? Well, you know it's flu season. And 2 weeks later, where's sister so-and-so? Well, pastor, you know, she laid up in the bed. She got the flu. Well, she prophesied it, didn't she? She signed for it, didn't she? And the devil showed delivered it too, didn't he? All right, let's go and look at something else. Because we're looking at some misunderstandings about divine healing. Let's look at God's healing can be lost. Do you know that God can supernaturally heal you of whatever, and it could be lost? You know, because a lot of folks say, well, you know, whatever the Lord do is done. Well, I wish somebody would have told Jesus that. Because he didn't seem to think that whatever God done, it gonna stay done in your life. Now, I know that sound kind of funny, don't it? Like, that don't sound religious. That don't sound Christian, what you just said. Like, whatever God do in a person's life, it's done. Well, let's see what he has to say. Turn with me to John chapter 5. See, because many people lose their healing by opening the door to the devil. And the way they open the door to the devil is by wrong thinking. And by thinking wrong, you allow the enemy to put that condition back on you that you was healed of. And many people lose their healing because they don't know their authority or how to walk the word of God out in their life. Let's look at John chapter 5. John chapter 5, verse 14. Are you there? Now, if we read John 5, we see that Jesus went around this particular pool, and it was all sorts of sick folks, crippled folks, waiting for the troubling in the moving of the water. And Jesus went and ministered.
Thank you for watching this broadcast of Educating the Believers with Pastor Curtis A. Merriweather. Pastor Merriweather invites you to come and experience the worship service at Faith Christian Church, Sunday morning at 10:30 and on Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. The church is located at 1215 New Savannah Road in Augusta, Georgia. Today's message is available in its entirety on CD and DVD for the price shown on your screen. Be sure to include the offer number shown on your screen with each product order. Please send your check or money order to Educating the Believers Ministries, P.O. Box 1049, Augusta, Georgia, 30903. If this message has been a blessing to you, we encourage you to show your support to this ministry by sending a financial seed to be sown to spread the good news by way of television. Pastor Merriweather would like to give thanks to all of you for your current, future, and past financial support to this program. This has been an Educating the Believers broadcast.